Let us discuss skidding of an automobile while taking a turn. Let us consider a circular track, or you can consider there is a straight road on which a car is moving and taking a turn, which is a circular arc of radius r. We know very well that when a body is in circular path, just to maintain circular motion, a centripetal force is necessary. Or we can say when the body is in circular motion, in the rotating frame, it experiences an outward centrifugal force. So here, say this car was moving with a velocity v. When it takes a turn to the left in a circle of radius r, we can say in radially outward direction, this car will experience a centrifugal force mv square by r. And this centrifugal force will have a tendency to skid the car in outward direction, but on its wheel, it will experience friction in inward direction. And if mv square by r is less than the limiting friction, the car will be able to take a safe turn, it will not skid. So we can simply state, for safe turning without skidding, we can write the friction should balance mv square by r, and this friction, it should be static friction, then only the car will be able to take a safe turn, as the wheels will experience an inward static friction. And we can simply say for skidding, mv square by r must be more than or equals to mu n, that is the limiting value of friction. Here we can simply write the normal reaction acting on car will be equals to mg. We can also analyze the situation pictorially here. If we just draw the cross section of the car, car will experience mg in downward direction on all of its wheel. Net normal reaction on car will be in upward direction. Car will experience a centrifugal force mv square by r outward, and its wheel will experience an inward friction, which is balancing this mv square by r. And at the time of skidding, the limiting value of this friction is equals to mu n, and here n is equals to mg. So we can write this mv square by r should be more than equals to mu mg for skidding. Here m gets cancelled out. We'll get the value of speed equals to root of mu rg. So this is the maximum limit up to which car can take a turn without skidding. If car speed is more than or equal to this root mu rg, the car will skid. So we can write here, for safe turning, speed of car must be less than root mu rg. This article you must keep in your mind, because this article is quite important for various cases. Whenever you will find a problem in which an automobile is taking a turn. Now we will discuss various cases of skidding of an automobile while taking a turn on a banked road. Here in the picture you can see a car is taking a turn on a banked road. In this banked road, for banking, the outer edge of the road is slightly elevated up above the horizontal. This elevation is provided because, as we have studied in the previous case, on a flat road, on increasing speed, the automobile may skid in outward direction. So on lifting the outer edge of the road in upward direction, we can say the road is banked, and due to banking, the normal reaction is slightly tilted. Like if we talk about the cross section, this picture is showing the cross section of this banked road, where this outer edge of the road is elevated above the horizontal, such that the road is making an angle theta with the horizontal. So in this situation, the weight of this car, mg, will be acting in downward direction. And if it is taking a turn in a circle of radius r, it will experience an outward centrifugal force mv square by r in the rotating frame. In the normal reaction, cumulative normal reaction on all wheels of the car will be n in the direction perpendicular to road. In this situation, if this angle is theta, along the road also we can resolve these forces. If this angle is theta, along the road in upward direction, the component of centrifugal force is mv square by r, and in downward direction, the force which is pulling the car in downward direction is a component of weight, that is mg sin theta. Now we are going to discuss various cases for the values of mg sin theta and mv square by r cos theta. In this situation, first case we'll discuss if mg sin theta is equals to mv square by r cos theta. So these are the two forces acting on the automobile along the direction of road. So we can state if mg sin theta and mv square by r cos theta are equal, the car will not be having any tendency of skidding neither in downward direction nor in upward direction. So we can simply state if mg sin theta is equals to mv square by r cos theta, this implies it will not have any skidding tendency. So we can write no skidding tendency will be there. In this case, here m gets cancelled out, and on solving we get tan theta is equals to v square by rg, or theta is equals to tan inverse of v square by rg. So this is the angle, we can write it as angle of banking suitable for a speed v with which if automobile is taking a turn, it will not have any tendency of skidding. Let's discuss various cases. What will happen if mg sin theta is more than mv square by r cos theta? When a speed is decreased, when automobile speed is increased, this will be more than mg sin theta. So we'll discuss various cases. Again here we can see the cross section. Let's describe the situation once again. The automobile will be experiencing its weight in downward direction, and while taking a turn, it will experience centrifugal force in rotating frame toward right or in the direction outward from the circle, and cumulative normal reaction will be perpendicular to the road. Now in this situation, we can see along the road the forces acting on it will be the components of weight and centrifugal force. These are mv square by r cos theta and mg sin theta. In perpendicular direction, the normal reaction will be balancing the other components of weight and centrifugal force. These are mg cos theta plus mv square by r sin theta. Now in this situation, if we just discuss our case 2, where we are going to analyze if mv square by r cos theta is more than mg sin theta, let's see what will happen. Obviously, this will happen when automobile will be taking a turn at a higher speed. Now, in this situation, we can say if mv square by r cos theta is more than mg sin theta, it will have a tendency to pull the automobile in upward direction. So, on its tires, a friction will act in inward direction. In this situation, this friction will prevent the automobile to skid in upward direction. So if there is a static friction which is acting, we can say friction will act in downward direction such that for safe turning, we can write friction is equals to mv square by r cos theta minus mg sin theta, because mv square by r cos theta is acting it in upward direction, mg sin theta is acting it in downward direction. So in this situation we can say this is the friction. If it is static friction, automobile will take a safe turn. Now here we can write this car will skid upward if this friction becomes equal to mu n, because the maximum limit up to which the friction can exist is mu n only. So we can write it as mv square by r cos theta minus mg sin theta, which is the friction, when it becomes equals to mu n, and the normal reaction will be balancing this force, it can be written as mg cos theta plus mv square by r sin theta. From this expression, this m gets cancelled out. On solving, we can get the value of speed. And if we just calculate the speed, this will be the speed at which the net outward skidding force is equal to the limiting friction. So the speed, we can see it is given by root of, we just take the common terms on one side and the constant terms on other side. So by taking this speed common, we'll be getting it rg into sin theta plus mu cos theta divided by cos theta minus mu sin theta. So this is the speed with which, if automobile is moving, it will skid in upward direction. So this we can term as maximum speed limit for safe turning. If speed is less than this limit, we can say the car or the automobile which is taking the turn, it will take a safe turn without skidding. But if speed goes beyond this value, it will skid in upward direction. Let us discuss one more case related to the similar situation. Here once again we draw the physical case. Mg is acting in downward direction. Centrifugal force and rotating frame toward outward to the circular track. Along the road, the components of mg and mv square by r are mg sin theta and mv square by r cos theta. In a normal reaction acting on it in upward direction, which is balanced by the inward components of these forces, these are mg cos theta plus mv square by r sin theta. In this situation, let us discuss the case 3, where we consider if mg sin theta is more than mv square by r cos theta. If mg sin theta is more than mv square by r cos theta, we can say if mg sin theta is more than this, this will have a tendency to pull the car in downward direction. So friction will act on its tires in upward direction, which will prevent the car to slide down. So we can say F will act in upward direction such that the value of this static friction F is equals to mg sin theta minus mv square by r cos theta, because this is the net sliding force and friction will be equal to the sliding force so that the car will not slip. And we can say if we decrease the speed below a particular limit, it may be possible that this value becomes such that it is more than the limiting friction. So we can say car will skid downward if this mg sin theta minus mv square by r cos theta, which is the value of friction, this becomes equal to limiting friction, which is mu n, and the value of n we can write mg cos theta plus mv square by r sin theta. As there is no motion in normal direction, this normal reaction we can write as mg cos theta plus mv square by r sin theta. Now here again m gets cancelled out, and remaining terms, if we rearrange, the speed will be getting as root of rg into sin theta minus mu cos theta upon cos theta plus mu sin theta. This is the limit we are getting, below which if the speed is decreased, the car will skid in downward direction if this angle theta is more than the angle of repose. So in this situation, we can say this is the minimum speed limit for safe turning if theta is more than angle of repose. So, be careful about all these cases. We have studied for taking a turn on a banked road.